After all the hype, the Manchester derby was something of an anti-climax, but it did highlight the contrast between United's home and away results. With only 8 points from a possible 18 away from Old Trafford, an unbeaten record counts for little. Sir Alex Ferguson's side have been shedding points in their pursuit of the defending champions, Chelsea.
This is a really difficult week to win, and points are going to be dropped between now and New Year, and I think it'll build up to a really fantastic run-in for the Championship, and there'll be points dropped in the run-in too, because that's the kind of league it is now. We have to chase Chelsea, and we're all after chase Chelsea. If you don't recognise who won the league the year before, then you're very foolish. It's not easy to win their week. Even though it's only by a point, you still win the week. And a very formidable, experienced side. And if anyone that finishes above Chelsea wins the week.
With three straight home victories, United have extended their unbeaten start to the season, but they've often left it late. At the Theatre of Dreams, they seem able to pull off last-gasp wins. Wolves pushed them to the limit at the weekend until a second from Jisung Park in the 90th minute gave them the 3 points. But now the focus turns to a rivalry that began 12 years ago between Alex Ferguson and Gerard Houllier as United travel to Aston Villa. The two enjoyed an intense duel during the Frenchman's six-year stint at Liverpool. At the end of that period, they were neck and neck with 5 wins each and 2 draws.
He's been a friend for a long time. I mean, even before I came to England, before the Liverpool experience, and then even after, I mean, we've been friends, and whatever happens on the field, we'll remain friends.
Villa have been plagued by injuries, particularly to their front men. John Carew and Emil Heskey are still out, though Gabriel Agbonlahor, who's just agreed a new 4.5-year contract, could start. Mark Albrighton's strike against Fulham last weekend ended a spell of 385 minutes without scoring. 3 more in a welcome midweek win against an albeit second-string Blackpool will have helped Villa's young side grow in confidence.
I regret that some of the players are not available because of injury or a long-term injury, but because in that sort of game you need probably sometimes more experience. But I'm quite happy to see some young players going through, and it would be for them a good experience, a good opportunity for the future.
In addition to Julio's own impressive record against Ferguson, Villa's most recent form against United isn't bad. Last season they won at Old Trafford.
Come on, you Villa boys!
And they held out for a 1-1 draw at home. The Villa Park faithful will be hoping to match that, at least with Julio at the helm.